you search YouTube for supplements for anxiety, you will find a multitude of videos claiming that some vitamin or supplement will cure your anxiety. This is no surprise since the supplement market is estimated to be worth $140 billion globally. These videos are often backed up by a convincing clinical study or trial supposedly proving that the supplement works. But do any of these supplements really help anxiety? And if so, which ones are the best? I decided to help you navigate this minefield of supplement advice. To do this, I spent a few weeks reading through clinical research papers available on reputable websites like the National Institutes of Health, PubMed and ResearchGate to see what I could find. The single trials quoted in supplement marketing can often give a misleading picture, so I focused mainly on systematic reviews. Systematic reviews analyse multiple trials and are designed to weed out trials of poor quality or risk of bias. I focused on the most common supplements I saw when Googling supplements for anxiety. Let's start with the vitamins B, C and D, which seem to feature in a lot of supplement marketing for anxiety. My search for vitamin B found this document, which said that most studies of anxiety groups showed no benefit for vitamin B over placebo. Placebo means some of the volunteers were given a pill thinking it's a supplement, but actually there was nothing more than sugar in it. This is because the belief that something will help can sometimes actually make people feel better. So vitamin B seems to be no more effective than a sugar pill. So let's see if vitamin C does any better. Finding reviews on vitamin C specifically for anxiety disorders was difficult, and most studies seemed to be small scale and limited to fish, rats, students or people with diabetes. However, a review published in the Journal of Nutritional Biochemistry concluded that high doses of ascorbic acid, that's vitamin C to you or me, was effective in reducing mental disorders including anxiety. It said that these studies suggest the potential of ascorbic acid as an anxiety-reducing agent, but conceded it needed further investigation in a broad population to ascertain this potential. So, vitamin C has potential but needs more trials. Well, that's a bit more positive, I suppose. Next, vitamin D. For vitamin D, I found this systematic review by researchers in Taiwan. Now, I'm a big fan of vitamin D, as since taking it, I've had far fewer colds, so I was keen to see if it is also effective for anxiety. The review findings were that vitamin D supplementation does reduce anxiety, but the effect is small. So moving on from vitamins, let's have a look at magnesium, which is one I often see mentioned on anxiety forums. This review analysed the results of 18 trials and concluded that the existing evidence is suggestive of beneficial effect of magnesium in people vulnerable to anxiety. However, it also said that the quality of existing evidence is poor, and well-designed trials are needed to confirm if magnesium is effective. We are always hearing how good for you omega-3 is, so surely that can help anxiety. This review from Taiwan looked promising, as it indicated that omega-3 might help to reduce the symptoms of clinical anxiety. However, the review acknowledged a number of limitations, including the modest number of participants in the trials, and warned that the findings needed to be considered with caution. And indeed, it seems caution was right, as a much larger systematic review funded by the World Health Organization was not at all positive. This review looked at 32 randomized controlled trials lasting at least 6 months, with over 46,000 participants, so a decent-sized study. It concluded omega-3 supplementation probably has little or no effect in preventing anxiety symptoms. So it seems a thumbs down for omega-3 also. So this is what I took from these reviews. Vitamin B, probably no better than placebo. Vitamin C, might help anxiety, but more research needed. Vitamin D, small effect on reducing anxiety. Magnesium, might be beneficial, but the evidence is poor. Omega-3, possibly beneficial, but probably not. So, not quite the same positive picture as the supplement marketing videos would have you believe. However, the human body is complex. What I learnt in reading these studies is how nutrition is important for the correct functioning of the brain. And if you are deficient in certain nutrients, it could at least theoretically affect your anxiety. So a healthy, balanced diet can only help. Also, some people may find certain supplements work for them, and it doesn't matter if it's just the placebo effect or something unique in their genes. If you find a supplement that does work for you, let me know in the comments. Or if there are supplements that you'd like me to research, let me know. But don't pin all your hopes on supplements, as there are other ways to help reduce your anxiety that are supported by much stronger evidence, and I cover these on my channel. So make sure you subscribe, as I've made over 50 videos about anxiety, and I'm making more all the time.